Now that RBI has given us some facts, we have something to talk about on demonetization. So here are some conclusions. One, if this was meant to be an exercise in economics, it has proved to be a complete failure because it does not achieve any economic objectives. In fact, it has caused a short-term devastation to India's economy, particularly for self-employed people. Number two, as many of us had said, as a political move, it's been a stroke of genius in the sense that it gave people of India the feeling that finally they had a strong leader who could take big risks. And Mr. Modi did that and came out of it. He swept UP, and I must say demonetization played a role in that. So as a political move, it's been a great success. The third thing that you can see from these figures is that no black money has been caught as a result of this. Because even if you say that some money has come in the banks and government will go after this, people who hold this kind of black money also are smart enough to make sure that this will not be tracked to them. There are two serious lessons that you draw from this. Number one, that the way to counter black money is not just to put enforcement behind corrupt people. You have to reform governance so generation of black money comes down in the system. And number two, when you take economic decisions, please go to real economists, because it's babas and, you know, faith healers of economics will cause more disasters like this in future. Because one thing that doesn't work in economics, it's a science. What doesn't work there is magic realism of the kind that was used to justify demonetization.